and just bring your left foot all the way up and in. So it's quite a good discipline to, you know, once we've had a lot of action, just see if we can get that stillness back quickly. See, if you find it easy, go to the wall, or even coming down to just the boards. Sometimes people's mats are a bit squidgy. So just drop the shoulders, push the palms together. If you're feeling ready, just lift and then open out into branches. Lovely. Nice. So just stare at something ahead of you. We're not in the wood. And just open wide like branches. And just try to get that leg poking really out to the side. Opening up the hips. Lifting the chest. Spread out the toes. And you like push with both sides. Push with the foot, push with the thigh. Good. Let's swap sides. So just bringing the focus back. Let's try it again. So, other side. Nice high lift. You can help your foot there. Fuse together. Hands come in. Push the shoulder blades back and down. And just lift. Once you've got that connection, really push. Push with your foot, push with your leg. Both hands. Let's see if we can do that behind our back. So push your hands together up between the shoulder blades. Lift the chest. It just makes you lift the chest a bit more. Really push. Well done. Breathe. Squeeze the glutes as well. Open wide that hip. Drop the shoulders. Gazing forwards. And we just come back and down. Just swing your arms, we'll just loosen everything and just press reset. Maybe do some shakes with the hands, get some energy to the fingers and blood in the hands. And the legs can be shaken. Well done. Okay, and then if we go facing towards the windows here and go nice and wide and just get that perfect, maybe about a metre apart with the feet. Just bring your hands in, pushing together, thumbs touching the chest. Roll the shoulders back and just bend the knees to enable you to keep a flat back all the way down. So roll the hips forwards, press weight down through the toes and balls of the feet, and just try and keep the spine straight. So you'll know when you have to stop there. So just bounce a few times here. Well done. Take some breath. Now this will help control how long you can stay here. And just shift the weight very gently, left to right. Just shifting the weight. Okay, well done. Okay, hold it. And then see, one foot at a time, if you can lift one heel off at a time, just alternately, lift, lift. Squeeze the glutes. And we're just going to do both together. So all the, well, at a time, but try and lift both off right up onto the balls of your feet. Imagine you've got stilettos on. Hold it there.
Imagine
that. Breathe. Yeah. That's it. That's it. So the girls should be better than the boys at this one. Good training. Hold and down, and then just come all the way back up again. Oh, well done. That was quite cardio, that one. Yes. Just do a bit of swinging. That's it. And just bring your hands back in. I'm just going to go down again and up. So we'll do six of these, really controlled. Straight spine down. And I think you'll find you start off again stiff by the end of this. Get a lot more movement, a lot more give in the muscles. So when you've done six, stay down. It is quite cardio. You can feel that connection between the thumb and the chest. You can really feel your heart go. So if you've done six, stay down. And just like wriggle around a little bit. Just get that feeling through the feet. You've got equal weight distribution. Lift the chest. Well done. Hold. Breathe. And come up again. Well done. Just then point both feet forwards and just imagine falling from the hips, flat back all the way.
way down. Let the arms just angle in front. Try and keep a really lovely straight spine, line of energy going from the head and out through the tailbone. And just drop the hands and just bend one leg at a time, left, then right. Can everyone undo that? Yeah. So we're just shifting away. Okay, we're going to do something that's going to save your hips. You're going to thank me for this because it's very hard, but it's the number one thing that's going to help our hips for future life. So bring your hands in together, bring them to your chest, and just bring the weight onto the inside of this left leg, and just lift the foot of the right leg. Ooh, it's really good for the hamstrings, this one. So then bring the foot flat to the floor and shift the weight again. So kind of pulling the chest up and back, and it doesn't matter if your heel lifts on the other foot, just shift the weight. Back and floor, timber, so shift. If it's too difficult to actually bring the heel up, it might help if you reach out, actually. That's a good tip, just reach out, because your centre of gravity shifts. So just reach, try and keep a flat back. It's the best thing you can do for your hips, apparently. Push. Let's do a couple more. It's quite Tai Chi, this, isn't it? Breathing as we go. Don't forget to breathe. We get the weight nice and on the inside. And then just bring your weight forwards, straighten the legs, and just roll up. Well done. Just bring the hands out front. Try and separate the fingers. So, well, you're sort of trying to separate the shoulder blades. You pull the hands. Feel this sort of relaxation between the shoulders. Lovely. And bring the hands to the back. Just knit the fingers together. Shoulders roll back. This is important. So you've got a straight back. Push the hips forwards. Don't let the lower back flick outwards. And we're just going to go all the way. Keep a little bend in the knee, a little micro bend. And then just send the chest forwards and the arms all the way overhead. So you can, if you can, bring yourself to the floor. Or, well done, that's looking good. So just breathe. And if it feels okay, just release the hands to the heels and gently pull. Pull yourself down. And just let gravity do its thing. Just let the head go heavy. Neck muscles are soft. Well done. And then just come all the way up. Nice and slow. And just point the feet out like that towards the corners of the mat. And just bring your hands down to the floor again. And we'll just walk forwards, walk forwards, walk forwards. And just let your knees gently drop to the ground and bring your forearms to the floor. And the thing here is that we push out of the forearms, lift the head and gently push back into the hip joints. So just keep a flat back here. So it's really important not to round the spine, just keep a flat back. Send the tailbone backwards. Just gently pulse. So you just really, this should feel a little uncomfortable. Yep, the frog. So take a few breaths there, just resting gently on the forearms. Really feeling that in the inner thigh. Then push weights down through the hands and come out the way you came in. And just bring your feet back into the center. Just leave your left hand on the floor and just open wide the right so you get a lovely line of energy going all the way up and back. Look in the direction of the hand. And then you can take the hand to the base of the spine just so you can just pull this shoulder round. And if you've got long arms like me, you can wrap your hand right round to where the thigh is and gently pull. Pull the chest round to the ceiling. Breathe. Lovely twist for anybody that's overdone it this weekend. Nice detoxer. So just swap hands. So we just leave the right hand under the face and push out of that joint. Nice straight line to start with. Send the the lower back outwards again, so no rounding, lovely flat back. Tailbone lifts and wrap the arm all the way round to the thigh if you can, and breathe, long neck. Lovely, well done. Come back, and just roll up really nice and slowly.